Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point. Thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky this month. Tonight, I'm going to be taking you on a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of August. We're going to be visiting several deep sky objects, and we're going to see what our nearest neighbors, the planets and the moon, are up to. So as always, buckle in, and let's see what's really out there. So tonight we're going to start off our tour with a planetary nebula, likely one of the most famous planetary nebulas in the night sky. This goes by the name of Messier 27, the Dumbbell Nebula. This famous planetary nebula lies 3.2 degrees north of the star Gamma Sagittae, and while it may be detected with binoculars, it is best observed with a telescope. A low magnification is really all that is needed to show its distinctive shape and some texture. Given that this is a bright planetary nebula, it is a great target for beginner, amateur visual astronomers and astrophotographers. Put in a nice eyepiece, and what you'll see is a nice hazy apple core shape that also gives this name the Apple Core Nebula. On top of that, no matter what level astrophotographer you are, this is a great target for wide and narrow focal lengths. Now, the next object on our tour tonight is an open star cluster, and one that looks exactly as the name it has been given. This is the Coathanger cluster. The Coathanger can be found with an easy star hop. Simply look for the star Answer, 3 degrees south of Albireo, and then look for the Coathanger, 4.5 degrees further south again. This is a little large for most telescopes, but it is a fine sight for binoculars. If you are an astrophotographer and enjoy photographing star clusters, the bright stars that make up this star cluster really stand out from the dimmer, fainter stars surrounding it. Now, the next stop on our tour tonight is a star that we just mentioned in the description of the Coathanger cluster. This is one of the stars that you use to star hop to the Coathanger cluster. This star goes by the name of Albireo. Arguably the most popular double star in the entire night sky, Albireo marks the head of Cygnus the Swan. Almost any scope at a low magnification will show a brilliant gold primary star with a fainter sapphire blue companion. This double star is not to be missed. Whether you have a large scope or a small scope, this is a treat to view through an eyepiece, especially for those who have never seen a double star through an eyepiece or those who have never looked through a telescope at all. It is a great first telescope experience. Now, speaking of double stars, Albireo is a double star, but there is another double star that we call the Double Double. This famous multiple star is easily found just 1.7 degrees from Vega, the brightest star in the constellation of Lyra. Binoculars show two white stars of equal brightness, but a telescope at 100 times magnification or more will show each star split into pairs of equally bright white stars yet again. I know from experience, my first time seeing the Double Double was very cool. Lower magnification was easy to see the two main bright stars, but then adding that extra magnification, those stars split into doubles yet again, and it was very cool to experience two double stars of equal brightness right next to each other. This was one of my most memorable finds through a larger telescope. Now, our next to last object is rather a celestial event happening within our own solar system, the Perseid meteor shower. The Perseids can usually be relied upon to put on a good show, and 2024 should be no exception. You'll need to stay up past midnight to have the best chance of seeing some shooting stars. The reason for this is twofold. Firstly, the moon is at first quarter and won't set until around midnight. Secondly, the shower reaches its peak between 9 a.m. and 12 p.m. Eastern on the 12th, making the early hours the best time to be outside. This is also when the constellation Perseus, from which the meteors appear to radiate, will be rising over the eastern horizon. It's therefore probably best to be outside somewhere between the hours of midnight and 4:30 in the morning, when the moon is below the horizon and the sky will have yet to brighten. If you've seen any of our previous videos, you may know that we get a lot of questions as to the best equipment to use when viewing the meteor shower. You don't need binoculars, nor do you need a telescope. You just need your eyes and preferably dark skies. Now, we are going to stay within our solar system, and we're going to see what the moon and the planets are up to this month. Mercury is challenging, but may be glimpsed low in the west at about 15 minutes after sunset for the first few days of the month. Look roughly 8 degrees to the left of Venus, which is now climbing into the evening twilight. A thin crescent moon hangs above Venus on the 5th. Both Saturn and Neptune are rising in the evening, but are best observed from shortly before midnight. Look for the just past full moon very close to Saturn on the 20th. Uranus remains within the same binocular field of view as the Pleiades throughout the month of August, while Mars and Jupiter put on a fine show for early risers. The planets are close to Aldebaran and the Hyades, with all three fitting within the same low-powered binocular field of view. Mars is just 0.3 degrees from Jupiter on the 14th, with a crescent moon nearby on the 27th and the 28th. As for the moon, it turns new on the 4th, with a full sturgeon moon occurring on the 19th. Well, that is it for our tour of the night sky tonight. Thank you so much for staying tuned. If you have any experiences with the Perseid meteor shower, let us know in the comments below. Additionally, if you've seen or even photographed some of the objects that we talked about tonight, we would love to hear what kind of equipment you use to do that. Again, my name is Teagan. Please remember to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future content on all things astronomy and astrophotography. Thank you so much, and clear skies.